Good morning and welcome to this episode of Breakfast with Bronsen. I am here with Dr. Gary Chartier. Good morning, Dr. Gary.
And good morning, Bronsen. It's a pleasure to be here.
Today we're going to be talking about the importance of being intelligent.
Okay.
First, let's define intelligence.
One of the widely held views that people have about intelligence that I'm dubious about is that intelligence is one thing. Psychologist Spearman talked about a quantity he called G for general intelligence, and the idea was that there was just one thing called general intelligence that underlay all the different mental abilities that people have. I feel like talking about intelligence as a big, broad, general category can be somewhat misleading. The fact is we've got all kinds of different ways of approaching problems, and people with different skill sets can come at the same problem and solve it, but drawing on quite different capacities that they themselves bring to the table.
I love that. I feel like everyone can be really intelligent. And they have their own lane of intelligence or their own specialty that they can like really be an expert in.
So I really like the idea of a distinctive lane that people have. The reality is, it seems to me, people bring different skills to the table. And one of the easiest mistakes to make is probably to think that if you don't arrive with the particular skill set that I've got, then you don't have some other complementary skill set that may be quite different from mine, but that may be really valuable for you. There's tremendous variety in terms of what people bring to the table, and it can be very exciting to discover what it is that really makes this person or that person stand out, and it may be really different from the way I am, and that's marvelous. That makes for a much better
world. Like, this world is such a better world for like many shades, I guess.
Absolutely
different. What would be like a couple tips that you could give to all my viewers out there if they want to find their own intelligence, if they want to become more intelligent? What are some things that they can do in their life?
You know, so one thing I would say, this just seems fairly obvious, but explore what you're passionate about. I mean, there's no guarantee, obviously, that what you're passionate about is also what you're good at. But here's what I can tell you. Being passionate is likely to prompt you to invest in particular skills and activities, and you'll find out what you're capable of by doing that. Number two, if you think about the work of the Stanford psychologist Carol Dweck.
Hi, Carol.
In her book Mindset, which is a popular treatment of her work, but she's done this in academic context as well. Dweck really emphasizes the degree to which confidence and discipline both contribute to developing what might otherwise have been latent or perhaps even non-existent skills. So it's not just a matter of being passionate, though I think that's really important, but also believing in yourself. I know it sounds trite, but believing that you have the capacity to develop and grow in particular areas. You know, this is not pop psych work from somebody on a TV show. This is a serious academic psychologist telling you that if you're committed and disciplined and diligent, you're willing to do what you need to do to keep growing in an area, you can do that. And believing that, I think, can make a tremendous difference.
If you would like to tell the world out there, here on the
world,
if you'd like to tell them one thing, what would you like to tell them?
There's nothing that matters more to me than connecting deeply and richly with the people in my life. I can't tell you that your life is exactly like mine. I can't say that what matters to me is precisely what ought to matter to you, because there are lots of ways in which a human life can go well. But what I can report is that caring deeply about the friendships and love relationships in my life has been profoundly enriching. And we live in a culture that sometimes encourages superficiality and disconnection. And I would just say, think about how much it might enrich your life to connect more deeply and give it a try.
Wow. Thank you so much, Dr. Gary, and cheers again.
Cheers.
And I'll see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Breakfast with Bronsen. Bye-bye.
Great to be here.